Let's say you are working on a project and you know how to set up Python in Power BI. As I said that your boss said that you need to run a Python script in Power BI and you already did a setup. So what's the next thing? So in my screen, I show you the pie chart, which is defined that how many percentage of people are taking different types of diet. Now, if you want to draw the same chart using this code, this Python code in Power BI, how can you do that? Hi, this is Krupali from KnowHow Academy. So let's start with me. So let me tell you what you are going to learn in this video. In this video, you are going to learn how to execute your Python script in Power BI and display the chart in Power BI screen. So first of all, what you need to do? First of all, you need to open Power BI, and as I said that you need to double check whether the Python script and the path is there or not. If it is there, click on OK. Now what you need to do, you need to first copy the script. Which script you need to copy? Let me show you. In my Google Collaboratory, I show you the script which is loading the data into the data frame. Now let me explain the script one by one, and let me explain the script line by line. So first of all, when you want to draw a chart in Python, you need to include one library. The name of the library is Matplotlib. So first line is saying that we are including Matplotlib library in Python. Now the second thing is that when we are loading data from Excel file to the Python, we need to load the data into the data frame. So for that, Pandas library is needed. Okay, I accidentally write two times Pandas library, so let me remove it. So Pandas is responsible for holding data in a tabular structure. Now let me explain you what data set I am going to use. So let me share my screen and show you the data set. Now this is the data set about the fitness. Now here the user ID, gender, their age, what is the height, what is the weight, what is the BMI, what steps they are daily walking, and so on. Now based on that data set, I interpret the information that how many person, let me show you here, how many person or how many type of percentage taking high protein diet, balanced diet, high fiber diet, low fiber diet, or low carbohydrate diet. Now here this column contains diet type. This column name is diet type, and it contains the data of different type of diet that particular user is taking. So I want to visualize this information using the pie chart. And I already did it in a Python. So how can I do that in Power BI? So let me first run the Python script in Power BI. Now the first task is that whatever data you are using, you need to load that data into the Power BI using Python script. This code is responsible for loading data from Python to the Power BI. Let me copy this code and go to the Power BI. Here, first of all, you need to remember when you are dealing with the Python data or when you are dealing Python code in Power BI, first of all, you need to load the data set. Now, you may have a question, each and every time we need to load the data set? No. If the data set is already there here in data section, then there is no need to load. But if it is not there, then you need to load it. Okay, so you need to click on Get Data, More Items, and here you need to write Python script, okay, and you will get, and click on Connect. And here you need to paste that code which you copy from the Python or which you copy from the Google Collaboratory. Okay, now as I explain code line by line, so I'm not repeating the code again, but here I need to change the destination of the file. Why? Because this file we are taking from Google Colab or Google Drive, but I need to take this file from my local computer. So let me show you where this Excel file is. So this Excel file is there in my download section. Okay, so let me copy this, and here I need to paste it. Okay, let me delete that code first. Okay, and I need to paste that. Okay, no, it's not coming properly. So I need to particularly copy the path from that. So let me just paste this file in my D drive, so it will be easy for me to. Okay, now let me copy the code and load it. Remember, always path you need to write it inside a single quotation, and instead of this slash you need to use this slash, and then you need to write this slash again and write the name of the file. So my name of the file is, let me go to the properties and copy the file name and paste it here. Okay, and then I need to write the extension. So the extension of file is .xls. okay, so xlsx. okay, so let me double check it. Okay, slsx. okay, so it is there. And here I need to write the sheet name. So by default my sheet name is sheet_sheet1. So I'm writing this, and here this code I'm removing it. Why? Because it will print the data. Here I don't want to print the data, so let me remove this and click on okay. Now here a Power BI is showing the screen from which I can download or I can load this entire data frame into my Power BI data section. So let me go again the code. Now see, this is the data frame which contain data from the Excel file. Now that data frame I want to load it into the Power BI. So that data frame df_data, it will show here, and I need to load it. If you want to transform it, you can transform, but since you are learning first time, so I'm directly loading it. So let me click on load. So it will take some time to load the data. Okay, so my data is loaded successfully, and remember, don't forget to save the Python file. So let me save it. Okay, so right now I am saving it under the D drive. Okay, otherwise, you know, if you want to use it in future, it will not work or you will not able to find it. So let me give a meaningful name, that is fitness data. Okay, and then click on save. Okay, now let's say we are finishing with loading the data from data frame to the Power BI. Now what is the next step? The next step is that whatever visual I have created in my Google Collaboratory, I need to execute the same code in my Power BI. So before loading the code, let me explain this code again. So first of all, what I did, I count the number of person who is taking the diet based on their diet plan. So these are the different types of diet plan available. So here in my Excel file, there is one column called diet type, and this code df.data, then you need to write a column name .values.count to dictionary. So it will convert this into the dictionary, and then whatever data it will load, it will assign to the diet.count data frame. Then this is the code which will display, or this is the code which will draw the chart, and this is the code which will give the title to the chart, and at last I need to write plt.show. This code will display the chart in Power BI screen or here. So here what you can do, first of all you need to go to the visualization pane, and you need to find Python visual. Once you click on that, it will ask to enable Python script or enable script visuals. So I need to click on enable. So here your Python screen is divided into two portions. First, that is a normal canvas, you are drawing your visuals in Power BI, And the second screen is that where you need to write your code. Okay, so let me copy the code from here. Okay, let me copy. And before copy the code, make sure here you will able to see the data. Now, which column you are using to draw the chart, you need to make sure that. So let me just expand that, and I am using the diet type column. So here this is a diet type column, and here you need to drag this column into the value, and then you should execute your code. Okay, if you do not drag a column here, then it will not give any result. So here automatically it will load the data into the data frame, and then I need to paste the code. Now here, see, this is a DF data which I am using as a data frame in my Python code. But here, whatever data we are loading from here to here, it will in this data set. So the name of the data frame which contain my data, the name is data set. So I need to copy this and replace it with the data, and then rest of the code, no need to change it. Okay, and then you need to save this code first. Save this code means if you write Control S, automatically whatever code you have written, it will save in the main PBIX file. And here you need to run the code. So here you need to run the script. Now here you will get an error. Now PLT is not defined. What it is saying? It is saying that whenever I am using PLT, it is not defined. Why? Because when I was loading the data, I load only the pandas and everything. But here, when I am using it, again, I need to import that matplotlib in my Power BI. So let me copy the code here. Import code, copy code. And let me write here the code. And let me save it and run it again. Now see, my Python script is executed, and based on that, in your Power BI, you will able to see the chart. Now let me just minimize this. And here, let's say if you want to increase the size, if you want to decrease the size of that thing, so you can go again to that, and here you can decrease the font size. Let me keep it as a 15. Okay, and again I need to run it. Okay, now here the title, here whatever I am displaying, it is not properly visible, so I don't want to display the title here, but instead of that, using Power BI, I will display the title. So let me comment the code here, again run it, and title is not there. Now here you can see the diet type. So if I want to give title here, how can I do that? So here I need to go to the formatting, and then let me just write a okay. And here you can change your color, text color, and change your style and everything. Rest of the formatting option, I am not giving the demonstration in this video. You are smarter enough to go and try out with the different formatting option. So you can try out this and you can check it. So this way you can draw different visual of Python in Power BI. Now you may have a question that if Power BI is supporting this different type of visual, then what is the need of using Python? But let me tell you that in Python, there are n number of charts which you can draw, which Power BI inbuilt visualization is not supported. Now, inbuilt visualization support limitation of the chart. But if you want to draw a box plot, here you cannot draw that. So using a Python visualization, and you can run your script here, and you can draw different type of chart. So I hope you understand that. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source of IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. If you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out to us. It has been a pleasure to share this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.